Further ado, I would like to call upon our president of Tunku Abdul Rahman University College, Dato' Dr. Tan Cheng Hock, to give his welcoming speech.
And our honorable guest from Malaysian Army Chinese Veteran Association, MECVA, you call MECVA or MECVA? President, Brigadier General Dr. Leong Wen Fung, Deputy President, Lieutenant Colonel Fabian Wong Wun Soon, Lieutenant Colonel Carol Lu Di Fan, Project Leader for this program. Major Godfrey Chang, Major David Cao, Major Ong, Major Chin, Major Anthony, and Captain Chai. Also welcome to our University College. I believe this is the first time you step into this campus, and this is definitely unprecedented. In IUC, we hope to work closely with MECVA, especially. At the table, we talked about taking in students from the past army and working out some kind of reference, giving them scholarship.
President of MACVA, President Brigadier General Dato' Leong Wen Fung, come upon his opening speech.
Now, back to the MACVA. As I said, our vision is to be a credible voice. A voice, trustful, trustworthy, can be believed, and so on. And we will work in that direction. We may not achieve it immediately, tomorrow, next year, but we will do everything we can, and with the support of everyone here and elsewhere, we hope to be there, all right? A voice to be believed, a voice that is credible.
Well, I would like to call upon Lieutenant Colonel Mohd Noh to give a speech on behalf of my director, Brigadier General.
We'll sharing their experience and will deliver the career talks on opportunity in the Malaysian campuses. First of all, I would like to express my sincere thanks to the Tuck University College President for accepting our team.
And our main task during peace, conflict and war. I think this one you know, right? And you should know. Okay, during peace, during conflict and during war. And our secondary task is as follows: to support and maintain public orders, to support enforcement, maritime law, to support offense, internal threat, and so on.
Apart from Kuching, I've been serving in Kuantan and now currently back in Kuala Lumpur
Air Force. Okay, I'm also from the NDU, UPNM. Previously was called ATMA, Academy of Turtle Nation. I'm the fifth batch from the NDU. Okay, I entered UPNM 2000 and graduated on 2005. I'm currently holding a degree in Mechanical Engineering As you said, we engineers, we need to be three-pointer and above.
Basically, what we do is to tackle and make safe any explosive ordnance that is detected in both rural and urban areas. This explosive ordnance can be divided basically into conventional ammunition and explosives, or you may know about what we call IED, improvised explosive devices. That one you can see a Rambo, Demolition Man, I think. All these are
extra hard work, and with our DNAs, especially the Chinese, and Sing, of course. I think we can just basically survive anywhere, right? Now, next, this will be the four categories that I would like to highlight to you all. First, we started off with school, right? We spent 12 years in the school, 1 year in the kindergarten, 6 years in primary, another 5 years in secondary, and then I went to the army, had my tertiary education there. Alright, I gained mass amount of knowledge, leadership skills, management skills, and then a lot of experience. Then, after 15 years, I left the service and joined the corporate world. Right, not so long, just 7 years, but this is where I gained a lot of networking. Right, you need to know a lot of people, and then a different set of experience here.
What I want to say here is that the army or the armed forces career is a very enriching career. Very, very enriching. You have seen some of the presentation by the MINDEF team. Gaji also okay. Privileges also okay. Opportunities also okay. It's up to you. You alone will make that decision. Me, you look at Anthony's presentation, he's a graduate. I'm successful now outside the armed forces.
Army veterans who has come forward to give you some of their experiences in service, after service. Major Chin has described a quiet, heroic army career. He's done dangerous things, but never boasted about it. And I've checked again, part of it was at bomb disposal or explosive device disposal. You need to be cool enough not to think about what is going to happen if I cut the wrong wire. Not like the movies. You just have to go by your training, systematically, bit by bit, step by step, do what you are supposed to do. Anthony, young man, still very young, under 40, but he is an example of using your brain, making full use of what is the role in the army. Learn what you can, get what you can, and then after you have left the army, still apply all that you have learned, use your experiences, use your training, use your leadership skills, use your management skills, use your networking, and of course, his engineer background and his very technical knowledge on IT. And then we have Major Godfrey Chang, who very modestly said nothing more than bomb fight when he joined the army. No big ambitions. Joined the army just because he wanted adventure, he wanted to go overseas. Right? And look what he has become. After 20 years in the army, right, because of opportunity and so on, he left. But he made full use also of what he learned in the army. And then apply. If you are at all interested, consider the army. We are not trying to twist your arm. We are not trying to brainwash you. We're just giving you the possibilities that are there for you if you are considering the army as a career. They have all said it is finally your choice. And what we are trying to do here is to tell you it is a practical choice, it is a good choice. Of course, in all careers, the rest is up to you. So with that, I thank all of you very much for giving us the opportunity to to try and present to you a little bit of the world that is the army, that is the armed forces. And we invite you to deepen your interest, and if it suits you, take yourself to join. If it doesn't suit you, continue to be interested, but go ahead and do something else. So with that, thank you very much, Dato. Thank you.